Now we had Psalm 31 verse 19. Oh, how great is your goodness, which you've laid up for those who fear you, which you've prepared for those who trust in you in the presence of the sons of men. Verse 20 goes on to say, you shall hide them in the secret place of your presence from the plots of men. You shall keep them secretly in a pavilion from the strife of tongues. Okay. You shall hide them in the secret place of your presence. Now, tell me, someone who's hidden, can people see them? If you hide right, if someone's in camouflage, they're hidden. You shall hide them in the secret place of your presence. If a person's hidden, can they be seen by other people? That's my question for you. If you're successfully hidden, can you be seen? Especially if God hides you. God has hidden you in the secret place of his presence. Surely only other people that can find that secret place of his presence would be able to see you. I mean, let me say this. If there is a secret place that you can go to be continually in the presence of the Lord God, to be in his presence all day long. If there is a secret place you can reach in the Christian faith, wouldn't that be a different and exclusive place to be in? When it says, you shall hide them in the secret place of your presence, wouldn't it be possible that you could be a Christian and no one understand you? Wouldn't it be possible that you walk through life with a tremendous presence of God over your life? Wouldn't it be possible that you could walk and make dynamic impacts with strangers and have tremendous impacts on their lives with short conversations? And yet around people who are supposed to know you, they have no idea who you are. Isn't it possible that Jesus was in the secret place? I mean, does verse 19 qualify? How great is your goodness which you've laid up for those who fear you? Jesus certainly feared the Lord, feared God. You've prepared for those who trust you. Jesus certainly trusted God in the presence of the sons of men. You shall hide them in the secret place of your presence. Jesus was a man of tears. Jesus' own disciples couldn't understand he was going to die on the cross. He told them multiple times, recorded in Scripture. Recorded in Scripture, there's many times Jesus told them he was going to die and on the third day rise from the dead. They couldn't understand it. Even Jesus was hidden. The disciples, I think, stayed with Jesus because they had no place to go. They'd given up their livelihood. But you'll find after Jesus died, he found them back in the boat doing fishing. He came back, they were back in the boats earning a living. They'd given up being disciples of the Messiah now. The Messiah's dead, so they'd gone back to fishing again. Not more than 3 days later, they were back in their village, earning a living again, giving up on preaching repentance and healing the sick. Does that sound like Jesus was understood by his disciples? Are we fortunate that Jesus came back for those 40 days in visions and in the flesh to meet his disciples and teach them what the resurrection and the ascension and the cross really was all about? If Jesus had gone back to heaven, Would those disciples have even really known him? Was Jesus Christ hidden in the secret place of the Lord God's presence? You'll remember Moses went up into the mountain for 40 days and dwelt with the presence of God. The mountain trembled and God spoke in thunder, and the children of Israel were in fear. They said, "We want to hear you speak, Moses. We don't want to hear God." Moses came down with a bright shining face from the secret place, from the presence of God. He came down and he had to wear a cloth over his face. Jesus went up on a hill one time with a couple of his disciples, Peter and John, I think, and someone else. And he started to glow as bright as the sun. The presence of the Lord came upon Jesus that he shone like the sun. That's when they should have known he was divine. Jesus was hidden too. So if you're living a life and you're hidden, if you're living a life where you just don't seem to connect on a deep level with many Christians, if you're living a life where you're absolutely almost stoned, if you've ever been stoned on marijuana, you're absolutely full of the Spirit and the presence of the Lord is heavy on you. And you're maligned and misunderstood by the average Christian. You're hiding in that secret place of the Lord's presence. You shall hide them in the secret places. Who has hidden you? Why are you hidden? Why doesn't the whole world recognize who you are? Why doesn't the Christian church recognize? Because God has hidden you. He's jealous for you. He's jealous of people's attentions of you. He wants to keep you specially aligned with him. You know, St. Thomas a Kempis wrote that if the Lord really loves you, you won't have any friends. And he'll keep you special to himself and close to himself. He said in his writings that the affections of men keep you away from God. Conversations with men keep you away from the presence of God and your ability to really dwell in the presence. Now, there's a song, "I love to live on a mountaintop, fellowshipping with the Lord. I love to live on a mountaintop, really feel my spirit soar. But I've got to come down from the mountaintop to the people in the valley below. 'Cause they gotta know about the mountain of the Lord." There comes a time where you've got to share Jesus and his light with the brokenhearted and the people that don't know him. Oh, it's a great joy to talk to strangers. It's a great joy for me to share the love of Jesus with people that don't know Jesus. I find it a little bit harder to fellowship with Christians who aren't devoted to Jesus Christ as much as they could be. There's many people that honour the Lord with their lips, but their hearts are far from me, from him, and their wallets are far from him. If you want to be hidden in the secret place of the Lord, you've got to do what verse 19 says. If you're not living verse 19, what we shared the first 30 minutes on, you'll never be hidden. And you'll never experience a strong presence of the Lord. Okay.